the power, which one's the brake?
No, no, sir. That's not how it works. Who's that, and why is he playing with the propeller? This guy looks
That's Grandpa.
Grandpa.
Yeah, don't make him mad. I'm going to tell you what, it'd be a bad day. All right, I'm going to take this thing.
All right, there's not much. We've got the F-22 coming up next, so we've got to get it out of here then. So you're going back behind the hangars. He's gonna drive it, as he says, taxi it back over there. They're going to take the wings off of it, put it on the truck, and get it out of here. And we've got to get a hold of Steve because they're repossessing his airplane. Meanwhile, as he's getting in there, we have the F-18 coming up. Hey, Grandpa, let him know that the F-18's coming up the taxiway here, because we've got to give a proper shout out to our team, including the Dancing Bear. And I saw how he got his call sign last night. It all started to happen. He started hopping around and dancing to the band down at the Beach Blast. So he's going to take this airplane, get it out of here, over to the hangars, get the wings off of it. And anyway, the Alabama boys is what they call themselves, repo guys. And this is, it's scary is what it is. Let me see if I get some appropriate music, calm us down. There they go. Oh, there's some of that FOD I was telling you about. We need to keep that in the waste bins and stuff, not out on the runway. Oh dear, he does think it's a brake pedal, doesn't he? Look at him. No, this is not a good idea. No, just tack to the left. There, he's got it figured out, I think. Even Grandpa doesn't know what he's doing. There he goes. Oh, you can just see there's something wrong there when you look at his eyes. That's just not normal. Oh man. All right, he's sorting it out. There we go. Now you're going in the right direction. Not too much power. No, we don't need the tip. No, not too much power. No. Oh, no, he's off the ground. This is not, that's not taxiing. That's flying, sort of. Oh, no, this is not good. I'll try and get him on the radio. We were so hoping he wouldn't be off the ground. See, he has no idea what he's doing. Grandpa, does he even fly? They don't know. Trees are a bad thing. This may end very shortly. There's the trees. Up, pull up. Get away. Back on the stick. Oh, man. Up he goes and over he goes. And maybe this will be the last we see of him. I'm not sure. Even Grandpa's starting to look worried here. He's behind the trees now. That's never a good thing. Here comes our F-18 crew. While we try and sort this out, give them a huge wave, including the Dancing Bear. Oh, Lord, he's headed back this way. And wouldn't you know, we got the fighter plane on the ground. We need it in the air. Maybe we could shoot him down. Up and down this guy goes. I'm going to try and get him on the radio. Sir, are you able to hear me on the radio? Are you able to even communicate?
Talking to me?
Yeah, not you.
Him.
The guy in the yellow airplane there. I'm even going to give up on the radio. Hey, Dancing Bear, it's crazy down here.
Crazy out here, too.
Saw you busting the moves last night.
Oh, always.
Well, we can't even communicate with the Alabama boys right now. I'm trying. Perhaps he's got at least the radio on to where he can hear me. He doesn't know how to transmit, and we're trying to talk to him to get it down and get this coordinated right and left, not brake pedals, but rudder pedals. A little to the left, everything's got to be a lot easier than that. There's the F-22. We'll get it up there to take care of him. As he continues to try and sort it out, I'll tell you, the air boss is a high level. So now we're getting him to just calm down a little bit, go a little left, a little bit right. And Grandpa, I don't know what we're going to do to get him back down. Trying to communicate with him. So apparently he is listening. And that's a good thing. And we're trying to get him to just see on the inputs with the control stick and the throttle and the rudder pedals and just tell it's way too much for this guy to deal with. So slowly, there we go. The power. It might be bumpy in the grass, but at least it'll all come to a stop. One wheel down the end. No, we have to coordinate this, not go back up into the sky. Oh, and a little waggle of the tail, because he's figured that out now. All right. Let's see if we can coordinate it in some kind of a landing, sir. I don't know if he's panicking in there or whether he's got it all figured out, but Man, if I didn't know any better, I'd say that's a pretty fancy flying. Wait, I think I can hear him screaming. Is that him? It is. He's totally gaslit. He is just absolutely strung. Kind of like my instructor. Grandpa, you're going to have to help. We're going to have to get him down here somehow. I don't care if you land him on the truck and take it back to Alabama with the wings still on it. Let's try and get this done because he's headed our way now. And you know, ladies and gentlemen, I think you got it all figured out now. I hope you didn't panic too much because the guy at the controls is very, very accomplished. His name is Greg Koontz. Greg playing the role of Clem Cleaver. Grandpa, Tommy Foster, thank you, Tommy. Grandpa's headed back to get the shotgun. I think he really thinks it's happening. Uncle Bob, Robert Duggar, Beaver Cleaver, their son, James Koontz. Dog, Rat Dog, the name, from a man who started flying in 1974, performing in a J-3 Cub for Colonel Mosser's Flying Circus. 22,000 flying hours Greg has accomplished. 165 different types of airplanes, instructor, charter pilot, corporate pilot. Runs a bed and breakfast aerobatic school on a private strip in Alabama where you can attend what he calls Sky Country Lodge. Greg specializes in aerobatic courses and upset training. And what he's going to do now after he flies some fancy aerobatics is Grandpa's going to head out with that truck and he's going to land on the pickup truck. You just can't make this stuff up. At least he's going to attempt to land on what has to be the world's shortest runway. So he's got to get it lined up, and Grandpa's deal, he maintained 60 miles an hour. And as they set that up, the very unusual, one-of-a-kind jet Salto glider is coming out. Bob and Lori, Bob Carlton, the award-winning pilot and designer, and retired rocket scientist, getting ready to take the stage in this remarkable aircraft. We've got to get back on the ground, well, at least on top of the pickup. So Greg's going to get turned around. He has very little time and space to get it settled on the top of the pickup truck. There's just enough room for the two main landing gears and the tail wheel. So he's going to get turned around, and Grandpa's going to hit the pedal, maintain 60 miles an hour, drive as straight as he can so that Greg Koontz can get the airplane to quit flying right at the right time to sit down securely on the back of that pickup truck. So here is the attempt, ladies and gentlemen, as Grandpa hits the pedal. Greg is lining up and slowly catching up. Dropping down now, sizing it up, getting used to the winds. We got a couple of gusts or so coming. That's not going to make it easy. He's starting to run out of room already. Now he's got to get a good look at it, around the sides of the airplane, hard to see over the nose. And he's going to feel for it to get the main gear on, but no, he's overtaking the truck. That's not good. That's not good at all. He's running out of space in a big way. Now he's got the main gear down. He's got to scoot up. He's got to scoot up to the front. No, he doesn't like that at all. But if I know Greg, he is not going to give up. Do you think he should try that again, folks? Do you think he should try it again? I'm not so sure, but if you are, well, he's all game. So we're getting Grandpa to get turned around again, and let's see if he can get it done this time. That is a beautiful J-3 Cub. Greg flies, as I mentioned, over 100 types of airplanes, teaches this upset training in aerobatics, and his Sky Ranch is just a perfect place to go do it. Bed and breakfast, you're treated well, and you're flying every day. How special is that? So here they go again, and they're going to try, as Greg gets lined up, Grandpa going straight down the runway, 60 miles an hour, Greg into the wind now, that's going to help him. It's still crosswind situation, though, for the most part. All right, here he comes. The air boss is totally confident with this, as you just heard. There, he's got the main gear down. Main gear down and rolling up to the front. Now he's got to get the tail wheel down and convince the airplane to stop flying. And they've got to do that just right. The truck has to slow down with him. Tail still up, so that means the wing still wants to fly. Slowly it settles down now right at show center. I think they've done it, ladies and gentlemen. A huge wave to Greg Koontz and this spectacular pickup truck landing, ladies and gentlemen. Grandpa's part in it as well. It doesn't get any better than that. But also now you've got the uh-oh moment because, well, they can't go back to Alabama like that, can they? He's got to take off again.